Hey guys, welcome back. And today we're going to talk about coffee. How much is too much? It's a question that keeps coming up. So let's just define what a moderate amount of coffee would be. That's 2 to 3 8-ounce glasses per day or cups per day, right? A high amount is 4 cups or more. Now, going through college, I was an extreme coffee drinker. I'm talking, I would drink pots of coffee, not just mild coffee, but Cuban coffee. Thus, all the health problems, the adrenal burnout, ulcers, etc., that occurred after that. So, what I want to discuss today is what happens when you drink too much coffee. Right now, I drink a very small amount of coffee per day. It's in the morning, it's a very small cup. It's probably, I don't know, 4 to 5 ounces. Just because if I do too much, it does affect my sleep. The biggest negative effect that coffee has on your body is the depletion of potassium. In fact, they use serum potassium levels, that's potassium levels in your blood, as a biomarker for acute caffeine poisoning. So let's just talk about what happens when you expose yourself to too much caffeine. So we're not just talking about coffee. It could be in sodas, it could be in sports drinks, it can also be in all the other things that contain caffeine, like tea, chocolate. So the first thing that large amounts of caffeine will do to your body is it'll increase your release of catecholamines. Now, what is catecholamines? Catecholamines are all of those things on the inside of the adrenal gland, like adrenaline would be a catecholamine. You have dopamine, GABA, noradrenaline. But for this video, we're just primarily talking about adrenaline. So when you drink coffee, you're stimulating adrenaline. And when you increase adrenaline, you lose potassium. Okay, so that's number one. Number two, you increase the sodium-potassium pump. Now, I've done other videos on this. Now, inside your body, you have all these little tiny cells. And in the cells, you have billions of these little pumps that are generating electrical current. And that has a lot to do with running your nervous system and your muscular contraction and your relaxation. And you need a lot of potassium for that. You also need this pump for energy. So when you start increasing the work on these pumps, you need a lot of potassium, and you get this shift from the potassium inside the blood going out of the blood inside your cells. So you're going to end up with low potassium in your blood. That's called hypokalemia. So that's another mechanism of why you lose potassium. You'll also increase something called diuresis. Basically, you're losing fluid. Caffeine can act as a diuretic, another way to lose potassium. You will also trigger something else called respiratory alkalosis. So your body starts becoming more excessively alkaline. And when you have that, you lose potassium. Now, if you're adding sugar to your coffee, you're going to add another layer or a complexity because you're going to spike insulin. And as you may know in other videos, when you spike insulin, you need potassium because you're going to be storing this glucose into the liver, into the muscles as glycogen, and you need potassium to store that. So you're basically going to deplete your potassium even more. And this also occurs if you're doing artificial sweeteners. And I haven't even talked about all the things that occur when you're low on potassium, like heart arrhythmias, fatigue, etc. In this video, I just wanted to point out and emphasize the biggest problem with too much caffeine is a loss of potassium. So if you're drinking a little bit too much coffee, make sure you add more potassium to the diet. But ideally, the best thing to do is just to consume a small amount of coffee each day. Thanks for watching. Before you go, if you have a question about a product, or you're new to keto and you want to know how to begin keto, or you're on keto and you need a debug because it's not going as smooth, I have a keto consultant standing by to help you. This is just for the people in the US. Hopefully, in the future, we'll be able to answer everyone's call. But I put the number down below so you can call and get some help.